Okay, so there's a new TTS system that's making the rounds at the moment, which is actually very interesting. This is called ChatTTS. It's basically a text-to-speech system focused on conversational text rather than narration or speeches and stuff like that. It has a bunch of things going for it. It also has some sort of drawbacks that I'll talk about during the video, and we'll also jump in and have a look at some code of how you can get it started and how you can try it out. I'm not sure a lot about the company that actually made this. When you look at their website, all their website says is we handle audio. And they're called Too Noised. I also suspect that they're probably not venture-backed because they've got a whole sort of buy me a coffee thing in here. But clearly they've trained a quite big model. So make of that what you will. It does seem to be a group of people out of China that have been working on this. One of the things with the ChatTTS system is it can do both English and Chinese. And they've put a number of demos up, and they've put a sort of guide site up as well, which has got some things which are confusing in it, which I'll go through. So on the whole, they talk about this being a model that's trained. It looks like it's a GPT model that's trained on 100,000 hours of Chinese and English conversation data. It is a bit confusing though, because they also talk about the large training data of 10 million hours. Now, I don't think that's correct. So to give you a sort of ballpark figure, OpenAI's Whisper was trained on about 680,000 hours of recorded audio speech. So in TTS, you would probably be able to get away with less than that. If you want a lot more coverage, then certainly 100,000 hours makes a lot more sense than 10 million hours in here. So it does look like this is their first sort of release. And I'd say the two drawbacks of this model, one, that it can be quite slow to run, and two, the licensing around this at the moment seems to be not for commercial use. Though they do mention that they're planning on open sourcing a trained base model, which you'll then be able to fine tune for various things. So that could be really good. And they actually talk about the idea of a trained base model being done on about 40,000 hours of speech in here. So they have a bunch of frequently asked questions where they repeat a lot of things themselves. Again, we've got the mention about the 100K. They talk about an API and SDK, although I haven't seen that anywhere yet. And then, like I said, they talked about that there is an open source version coming where the team plans to release an open source version trained on 40,000 hours of data. And hopefully that will be licensed in a better way. I can see that, just having a look at the project quickly, I can see that, you know, if they were to open source something, I do think the community will definitely get behind it and will speed it up and do a number of different things to make it easier for people to use it. Currently, it's more a sort of research release in here. So they do talk about, can it be customized for specific applications or voices? And they say yes. And in my experience, it's basically like a lot of the TTS systems where it's making an embedding to represent the person's voice. So by manipulating that embedding or just sampling lots of embeddings until you find one that you like, you can actually select the voice that you want that way and use it for what you want going forward. Obviously still limited by the fact it's a non-commercial license. Anyway, let's jump into the code and have a play around. Let's see what it can do. It does have some really nice features. It certainly can create some nice voices, even though they're slow to actually run. Let's jump into the code. Okay, so looking at the code, they do have a GitHub repo up, which has got a lot of the stuff I'm going to go through and show you. It's got a bit about how to set it up and stuff like that. They also have a Hugging Face page where the model is actually being stored, where you're actually downloading it from in here. And that, again, talks about the basically non-commercial license in here. So let's jump into a collab and actually have a look at getting this going. Okay, so you will need to install their GitHub repo, clone their repo, install their requirements. You'll also need to install this Nemo text processing I found to basically get things working. And then you can just load the models, and this will get the models from Hugging Face. So you'll need a Hugging Face key in there, I think. It certainly asked for my key in my secrets in Colab here. And once you load the model, you can basically just do batch inference for things. So you can see here that, okay, I'm bringing it in and I've been messing around with getting it to just say, okay, TTS doesn't come out that great.
ChatTTS is a cool new tire system from Too Noised.
doesn't come out that great. And you're really going to find that the quality of the voice depends on the sampled embedding that it gets.
I wonder if there will probably be a faster version of chatouts.
Okay, with these ones, so it's important to understand that when you basically are doing this chat infer, you're just passing in text. Now, you can pass in a list of different texts if you want to do batch inference, and then you can basically just index into these for the batch when it comes back for trying these out. But you can also pass in other things as well. So let's look at the first thing you can do is pass in this inference code. So this is where you can put in some things around the prompt. This is sending in tokens for things like the speed, telling it what paralinguistic features you can put in there. So I'll talk about this a little bit later on. And you also can pass in things like your top P, your temperature and stuff in there. And then once these are passed in, they're used for the generation. So you can see here, I've basically got, hey there, how are you doing today? Let's see how that came out.
Hey there, how are you doing today? I was just wondering, what are you doing at 3 p.m. today?
And it came out pretty good in this one. Now, the problem is here is that because we've just done the inference without controlling how we pick the speaker, we can't easily get that speaker back, right? It's basically sampled down a speaker and we're unable to get that. So what you probably want to do more often than not is set a speaker. And the way you set a speaker is you just pass this into the inference code. So you're basically just doing a random speaker, chat sample random speaker. You'll then pass it in just like you would with everything else. So you can basically pass in the inference code or the refined text thing. I'll cover the refined text in a second. But the cool thing is by doing it this way, if you happen to like the speaker, you can then reuse them. All right.
Hey there, how are you doing today? I was just wondering, what are you doing at 3 p.m. today?
Okay, let's say I like that speaker. I actually probably liked the speaker before better. But if I like that speaker, I can see that now, okay, that speaker is just basically a vector, which is an embedding in here. And that represents the speaker. If we look at it, we can see that it's a vector of 768 in there. And if we want to use that speaker again now, because we've saved that random speaker, we can just pass it in again. So you can see now I've changed the text, but I'm going to have the same speaker speaking it.
It would be great for us to catch up and have a coffee.
Okay, so this is a good example of where, okay, now we've kept that speaker, we could reuse that speaker. Now, if we just basically save, we could just save this to NumPy or something like that. We could actually reuse the speaker as many times as we want. Even in other sessions, we could just load up this embedding and that will be a representation for that speaker in there. All right, the whole thing around refined text is, this is kind of interesting. So what they've got in here is that if you just pass in text and do something else out, so it will take the text that you've got in, and at this sort of refined bit, it will decide what are the paralinguistic features that would be suited to your text. So you can see here, it's basically, all it's done here is basically add a UV break in here. If we look at one of the ones down here where I'm talking about a little bit more, we can see we've taken, this is one of their examples. It's quite a long sentence in here, and it's decided where to put breakpoints in there. And so that does one pass with just refining the text, and then you can use that refined text to actually make, you know, an inference in here.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for watching the YouTube channel.
Okay, so the use of this prosody and paralinguistic features, just to show you another example of this. So this is a long sentence, and it's generated out the breaks in here. And by going through and we can see where those breaks are, you'll notice now that when we actually play this audio, that it will have breaks at these points.
So we found being competitive and collaborative was a huge way of just staying motivated towards our goals. So one person to call when you fall off, one person who gets you back on, then one person to actually do the activity with.
Now, those things are being put in there. That's the refining text stage. We can actually do this ourselves. So if you come and look here, we can see that, okay, we can just pass in text with these special tokens in here. And just jumping forward, if you want to see what tokens are available, let's look at the tokenizer. And we can see we've got laugh, we've got break, we've got oral, we've got speed, the different things that we can pass in here. Anyway, if we come back here, we can see this time what I've done is I've put in a laugh after goals. Right? Perhaps not appropriate or not, I don't know. But anyway, I've put that in there. And you'll see now when we generate.
So we found being competitive and collaborative was a huge way of staying motivated towards our goals. Anyway, so one person to call.
So there you could see that, okay, we got the laugh there. Now, you will see that it often will add in some words. So it's after the laugh, I had to recover that. So it said, so anyway, so one person to call. When you play around with these things, it can actually add in other words. Not that they're like random words. They're more like words that would occur after a break or after a laugh or that kind of thing. Using some of these things, you can get some basic prosody happening. You can get some of these paralinguistic features in there. Some of them you can actually quantify. How much of it do you want? You can see here, laugh one, laugh two. So experiment with those. From my experience, they seem to change exactly what they do from voice to voice. Certain voices respond to them more, certain voices don't respond to them that much, that kind of thing. But anyway, this gives you an idea of ChatTTS. Like I said, it is a very impressive TTS system. Unfortunately, the license is non-commercial at the moment, but hopefully if they release a open source version, then we'll be able to use that and fine tune it for a variety of different things, etc. Anyway, as always, let me know your comments below. If you've got any questions, etc., put those in the comments below as well. And if you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe, and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.